Okay, we're going to start on the electronics. We're going to go ahead and put on the 4-in-1 ESC. We're using this particular ESC. This one. There's many different types of 4-in-1s that you can use, but we're going to be using this particular one on this build. I've already soldered on a battery connector. So let's go ahead and get it installed. Top, this is the bottom. We're going to pull the bottom plate off. Again, we have some noise going on in the background. That's just the way it is today, though. Okay, we're going to install the plug here. So it's going to go in like this, and this plug is going to come around like that when we're done. Okay, so we want to put this, you know, about in the center. So get it as close as you can, and you have some screws here. You want to put it in between those like that. Okay, so that's pretty much where I want it. You know, make sure it's kind of, you know, squared up this way. Make it look nice. Okay, so let me go ahead and mark these holes. Okay, we're going to use the 16th inch bit. And I'm only holding this up so you can see it. It's really better if you, you know, put it down like this to drill it out. So we'll do a couple of them this way also. Okay. 3/8 long screws. And again, we want the plug to go there. You want to make sure you don't pinch any of the wires. So after you get it started, you just want to make sure that the wires are pushed aside and you don't pinch it. And you'll see that it sticks up a little bit. It won't hurt anything. I'm going to only put 2 screws on this. You can put all 4 in when you build it. Let me line that up. Make sure your wires are aside. Okay, and then you can put the other 2 screws in. Okay, that's done. You want to make sure that you run these 3 wires, you know, to each motor. Don't cross them up. 3 wires for this ESC, and this ESC goes to their respective places. Now this is going to be motor number 1, 2, 3, 4. So if we take it, this is actually motor number 4, and 1 is actually over here. We're going to fix that in a minute. Okay, but let's just get it all over there now. And then you'll see These wires are going to go this way, and they're going to your controller inside in a little bit. These wires are going to come around like this, and we'll put this right to the bottom of the plastic, just like that, right where the wood, just like that. And we're going to get our 16th inch bit again. I use a very small screws. We'll level it up. And we'll drill this one. Use a small screw again. And that's our battery mount. Take note here. This is motor number one. And again, these are the wires going to motor number one, and it's actually going to be four. So motor one, is going to be ESC number four. This is going to be motor number two. And it's going to ESC 1. This is going to be motor number 3. It's going to be ESC 2. And this is going to be motor number 4. And it's going to ESC 3. Okay. We'll remember that. Let's go ahead and put our bottom back on. I think it's pretty safe to do that. Well, we'll wait a while. So let's go ahead and put our controller on. We're using a CC3D, that's what you guys have. And be honest with you, I know it's not the newest that there is, but it flies really, really good with a CC3D, especially if you're just going to be cruising around. You can go fast with it and all that. Now, motor number one is going to ESC 4. So 4 is white. So this is going to go to number one. Let's go ahead and get this CC3D put on. Put a couple of pads on here. And if you remember, ESC or motor number one was going to ESC 4. ESC 4 is white, and this is it. And we want to, the signal is on top, and it shows it right here. Signal is on top, power is in the middle, and the ground is at the bottom. And here you show your motors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Number one's there. Signal's on top. I'm gonna put it on just like that. Motor number two is ESC number one. ESC number one is brown. So we'll put brown as motor number two. Three is ESC two. ESC two is red. And we only have one wire here. That's our signal wire. We want it on top, just like this. And again, motor number four is ESC three. ESC three is orange. Okay, just the way we want it to go. So we're ready to install it. Let's bring the wires here. You see the arrow here? That's direction of flight. So this is the front. We're going to install this just like this. Now what we want to make sure is that we're going to be connecting the computer right here to the USB, micro USB. So we want to make sure, you know, we have room enough to do it. So let's bring this around like that, and we're going to make sure we can plug it in. I think right in here it looks good. You want to make sure it's straight this way, as good as you can. And I think that looks good, and we can plug in our USB right here. That's good. Okay. So just make sure it's straight this way, the controller. Looking good. We can tidy up all these wires after a while. Well, that's not too bad. We can just move them in like this. Make it look a little bit neater. We can put a tie band right there a little bit later too, or a zip tie. Okay, we're done with the controller. We're done with the ESC. Next, we're going to install our receiver, and it's going to plug into here, and we're going to do that in a minute. Let me show you how the camera is going to go on. This is a camera system. It's a one that we're going to use. We've had it for a little bit, and this is a camera. We're going to install it right here in front, and you'll see that it fits in between those, and we're going to again put it flush at the bottom, and we'll get our 16th inch bit again. And we'll drill a hole, not all the way through, just about halfway through the wood is all you need. Again, we're going to get a 3/8 long screw. Let's go ahead and put a washer on. And we have our VTX, and that's our video transmitter. We have a washer and a nut. Okay, we're going to install this right flush to the bottom, to the back right here. Just like that. And again, we're going to use our 16th inch bit. And you'll see right in here, we'll drill us a pilot hole. Not all the way through the wood, about half. We'll get our 3/8 long screw. There we go. We're going to put our video transmitter in. Then we're going to put a washer. And the nut. We want to make sure that's tight. Okay. You have a button right here. Something there. You have a button right here, and this is where you'll change your channels on your VTX. Now, this wire here is going to go to your camera. You always want to double check polarity. This says 5-volt ground in your video. Red is always your power, so we'll turn it this way. And we'll plug it in. We can trim up these wires a little bit later. We'll fix all those wires and then we'll probably, again, put a wire tie like that. That's what I would suggest. Make it look nice before you put your cap on. Another thing to remember, never apply power to your quad if you have a VTX, a camera system here, FPV camera system. Never apply power to it unless you have the antenna on. If the antenna is not installed, it can burn your VTX out. So always make sure your antenna is put on. You have a couple different types of antennas. The connectors, this is called an RPSMA. It has a pin here. And it's got a hole here where it connects. They make a couple of another different type. Always make sure you have the proper antenna for the connector. Good way to tell is just look at it. And look at it, you'll see that if there was a pin here, they're not going to match. So you want to make sure you have the right one. Screw that on. And now next is going to be the motors. And we're ready to apply power and then set up your CC3D and go fly. Okay, let's put the motors on. And I'll go on like this. Leave them loose until you get them all on. After you get them all on, I just normally grab one opposite of each other and just pull. And the same here. And pull. And you'll see that it snugs it down really good, tightens up real good. You can also use, you know, needle nose to tighten it up if you want. Either way, as long as it's pulled down and it's, you know, tight to the motor mount. Let's go ahead and cut these off. I cut them smooth with this piece here, if you leave it a little bit long, it'll, you know, pinch you or stick you. So just cut them tight. And then we'll bend these around. We'll connect them up. We'll check rotation on each motor whenever we do the setup on LibrePilot. But for right now, we'll plug them in like this. And when it's all finished up, it's going to look really nice. So we'll put a tie band right here and make them look really nice. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm putting the wires all on the inside. Okay. Let me go ahead and plug in the motors. Looking good. Let me put a zip tie on this. Next, we're going to put the receiver on for our transmitter, and it's going to be installed here and it's going to plug here. I have to do a little bit of soldering to it. I'm going to do that. I'll come back and we'll do the installation. We're going to be using a Turnigy Evolution radio, and for the receiver we're going to use an FSA8S. Okay, and we're going to be running iBus protocol. So to do that with the CC3D, we are going to plug into the flex port here and of course into the receiver. We'll do the setup when we get into LibrePilot, but for right now let's keep the polarity, ground, power, and your iBus. And there we go, and we're going to plug in to the flex port. And if you notice on this plug, we're using the ground, the positive, and then we skip one wire, and then we use the signal wire here. So we're going to do a little wire management there, and we'll put it here. So let's get a sticky pad. And we'll cut it in half. We want this to be double thickness. Actually, I quite wouldn't in half, so I'll just cut another one to match. Trim this off a little bit. And then we're going to... this. Get us a zip tie. And yeah, we'll do it this way. And I didn't catch the wires on this one. And we'll pull this tight. Some shrink tube, and I'll put some of this in your kit also. I'll make sure that gets into your kit. And we're going to use this to hold our antenna. And we'll get some heat applied to this to set that. Now we're ready to put the top and the bottom on. So let me get that done. Okay. We have the top put back on, the bottom put on. It's completed. All we have to do is put it on the Lieber pallet. First of all, we'll set up the radio and we'll bind the receiver, and then we'll set up the 200 mini on Lieber pilot, and then we're ready to fly. We're also going to, let me do this now. Okay, we're done. We're ready to put it on Lieber pilot, put the straps on. You can do it after you put the plate on, much easier before. So do this, put the plate on, easy. Go ahead and I put the loop on this side and the hook on the battery. So I went ahead and put that on, you know, kind of even with this right here, and put it in the middle this way. And that's it. Let's get the transmitter set up, the receiver bound. Get it on a Lieber pilot, and we're ready to fly. This is Dana with Quad Legs. See you in just a little bit.